At least 10 political parties, including the insurgent group National Socialist Council of Nagaland, Isak Muiwa, have decided to boycott assembly elections in Nagaland. The ruling Naga People's Front, the BJP and opposition Congress have also reportedly signed the declaration to boycott the polls. The political parties have been demanding conclusion to the Naga peace talks before any elections are held. The assembly elections are scheduled on Feb 27. The Naga insurgent group NSCM-IM is in talks with the central government, and the two sides have signed a framework agreement in August 2015 to resolve the crisis, but there has been no breakthrough in talks since. Meanwhile, Indian Deputy Home Minister Kiran Rijiju has reportedly said that both central government and the BJP will ensure that elections are held on time. Kiran Rijiju is Minister of State in Home Ministry.
Has planted this news?
I'm joined by my colleague Raghvin. Raghvin, how complicated is this issue when it has to deal with one, that the whole Nagaland Accord has not been made public? Second, the concept of a greater Nagaland, which is known as Nagaland. And third, elections not being fought by majority of the parties, despite the notification being issued by Election Commission.
Indeed, Karthikeya, a very, very complicated situation. For years, there has been this demand to set up a greater Nagaland. Now, the demand envisages setting up of a separate Naga country, so to say. And if that were to be set up, as envisaged by those fighting for it, it would include areas from Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, and even Myanmar. The Modi government, they have signed an accord with the Naga insurgents. The contours of that accord have not been made public so far, but the center has assured on more than one occasion that implementing this Naga deal would not encroach on the land which falls in the neighboring states of Arunachal, Assam and Manipur. In fact, Prime Minister Modi, before the Manipur elections, had even made the statement in Manipur saying that Manipur's land will not be taken away for the cause of this deal, the Naga deal, which the center has signed. So despite all these concerns which have been allayed by the center over a period of time, ever since this pact was signed, those fighting for the Naga cause, they are getting increasingly impatient. They think that allowing elections to the state assembly at this point in time will impinge on their cause. They feel that they are close to sealing a very fine deal with the government of India, and they think that allowing elections at this time may jeopardize the kind of bargain or the kind of deal they may end up getting from the Modi government. That's the reason why most of these parties have decided to boycott these elections. Now the state, the central government rather, they have been trying to convey to these dissenters and those parties who are not wanting to contest these elections that conducting elections is a constitutional requirement. The assembly's tenure is going to expire and a new assembly has to be set up. But put together, it indeed makes for a very, very complicated situation, and a situation that could snowball in the days to come.